Hello again, and welcome back to another one. And today we have a couple of topics to cover, from heated debates on the most famous rapper in the world that sparked some wild takes, to more on Kendrick Lamar, who was recently named the GOAT of this generation, that caused debates on social media as expected. And we also have more that links Eminem to Kendrick's music video for The Hard Part 5. And here's something that adds to the last story we covered on this channel, when the quote, "Eminem went out sad" party was cut to just 2 days in 2022, and a user on Twitter decided to rub salt in the wounds with this post, "Days Eminem and Mariah Carey have outstreamed each other on Spotify. 2021, Mariah had just 3 days, and it was cut to 2 days in 2022. Talk about pettiness extraordinaire." A recent article from the New York Times sparked debates online that goes, Kendrick Lamar's new chapter, Raw, Intimate, and Unconstrained, in partnership with his longtime collaborator Dave Free, the greatest rapper of his generation, is pushing himself, commercially and creatively, onto unexpected terrain, and J. Cole and Drake fans especially were like,
"Say what?"
And this sparked some interesting takes like, Kendrick has one classic album, Good Kid, That's It. The rest have been okay albums. Good Kid, Mad City was perfection though. He's the most overrated rapper since Pac. Lil Wayne better, Cole better, Drake better, Jay-Z better, Nas better. Nas and Jay gotta be included, as they've had recent albums. I guess this user missed the part where it said, quote, "greatest rapper of his generation," and this one sparked another round of debates under. Just goes to show the standards of hip-hop has dropped dramatically. If this guy is considered the best of his generation, he's not even on the stratosphere of early Dre, Snoop, Biggie, Tupac, or Eminem. Legends like this, and this generation has Kendrick Lamar facepalm emoji. The point of lower standards was brought up a couple of times. Kendrick Lamar's music is mostly mid. Sure, he's a good artist, but he's not the quote greatest rapper of this generation. When it comes to the rap game, no one from this generation comes close to Eminem. Other honorable mentions are Lil Wayne, J. Cole, Drake, Nicki Minaj, Nas, and T.I. But overall, apart from the Cole and Drake fans, many seem to agree with the New York Times on Kendrick being the GOAT of this gen. It's a fair statement, and this take put it nicely for the most part. I don't agree and I don't disagree either. Laughing emoji. From the same interview, we got to find out something interesting about The Hard Part 5 when Kendrick used deepfake technology to morph into OJ, Jussie Smollett, Will Smith, Kobe, Nipsey, and apparently nearly included Eminem in the lineup. Check this out. The seeds of the video's concept were sown a couple of years before its release, during a time when Kendrick and Dave were thinking about polarizing figures, how people behave in and out of the hot seat, whether a public figure can reveal his flaws and maintain wide acceptance. What's far afield of the Overton window? Quote, "I look at everything as a social experiment," explains Dave, who directed the video with Kendrick. Around the time of those discussions, Dave and Kendrick had a meeting with the creators of South Park, Matt Stone and Trey Parker, with whom they are developing a live-action comedy. Stone, who with Parker owns a company specializing in deepfake technology, offered to show it to them. Quote, "You see, Kendrick turned into Tupac, Kendrick turned into Ye, and I think we had Eminem," Stone told me over a Zoom call. He told Kendrick and Dave that they could be among the first to use the technology for one of their videos. On their way out, Dave and Kendrick turned to each other and exclaimed, quote, "What if we did the Jussie Smollett?" A few hours ago, Hot Freestyle started some fire with this. Who's the most famous rapper in the world that's still active? And while some believe between Snoop and Eminem, but Ice Cube too, Drake, but he ain't really a rapper. Some had more spicy takes like, "I want us to stop forcing Eminem in these conversations for real." Like, I'd love to understand the thought process behind takes like these. The name Eminem seemed to trigger some people on site. And this sparked responses like, "Let me guess, your brother's cousin deserves to be on that list instead?" Another user responded, "How the hell someone quote forcing Eminem in these conversations when Eminem have a legit argument to be the most famous rapper worldwide, lol." And based on the metric of Google searches worldwide, some dropped this that compares them by region. Eminem is in blue, and even the red in East Africa that represents Ye is already debated under. The small red in East Africa is my country, and Eminem is more famous and popular than Ye. Well, this is just one metric of many, and we all know when it comes to global reach based on streams, Eminem is number one in most countries. Most viewed on Wikipedia also goes to Eminem. And what are your thoughts on this one? Everyone who knows Eminem knows who Snoop is, so I think it's between those two. You can probably find pockets in remote areas who don't know who 50 or Lil Wayne are, but I doubt you find anyone who doesn't know both Em and Snoop. Not one or the other, just my opinion. Thoughts? Tell us below. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe if you enjoy content like this, and see you on the next one.